two, three. Gotta get those jumping jacks in. I'm being silly. Tammy T. Walker, life coach, therapist, social worker. Hit subscribe and hit like. Today's video is about what motivates you. I'm gonna need some feedback on this one. I'm gonna need your help to tell me what motivates you. I was having a great talk with my god sister like I'm always doing, and that's precisely what we were talking about. I was telling her what motivates me, and she was telling me what motivates her. For me, I told her if I'm angered by something, or I feel like it's an injustice, or I feel like my value is not being met, that will inspire me to do better. For an example, last year I was working a job, my salary was low, and I was driving all around, you know, trying to help youth get jobs, but it was counterproductive, not what I was doing. That was a beautiful thing, but spending so much money on gas and the low salary, it just didn't work for me. Plus, I was in traffic for like an hour and 15 minutes, and that was a lot of time that I could have been doing something else. So one day I just got really fed up and jumped on Indeed, applied for 20-some jobs, and that's how I ended up with this HR job that I'm currently doing in conjunction with my therapy. So it works out really well. So what is it for you? You know, some people, they're motivated by if they want to lose weight, maybe they're going to be in a wedding, maybe they're getting married. They'll use that to motivate them to drop the pounds. Maybe someone wants to start their own business. That's a great motivator. You know, that takes hard work. So they'll set up their business plan. Goals will be set, and that's going to motivate them to achieve those, you know, goals or plans. And nothing is better than having freedom from working for someone and having your own. So that's another great motivator. Many people are motivated by their family. Many men I've heard tell me, once I had my son, I changed. Once I had my daughter, you know, it made me more serious. And I always feel inspired when I hear that. Because that's just such a beautiful thing. And we know, give it up for the moms and the dads. Happy Father's Day, too, to you dads. I know I'm a little late. But moms, you know, that's just nature's, you know, instinct to protect their young and their baby. I mean, I double dog dare you to go mess with a jaguar's baby. You will not have your face or your life because they're going to rip you to shreds over their baby. Same with a tiger, a bear. You know, even a bird will peck at you if you try to mess with the baby chick. So these are things that motivate many people. But what is it for you? And I hope I have some of my viewers. I have some great viewers. And I'm sorry, I hope I don't mess up your names, but I know Miss Sharon C. We got Nature Simplistic, Stack 44. I watch Coach Warren. He is phenomenal. And Ron Willis is phenomenal. Raph Smart, Infinite Waters, these are people that inspire me, their videos. So if some of you are watching, what got you to start your YouTube channel? If you could drop me some comments, that will help other viewers that really want to step outside the box, but they don't know how to get started. Now, I will tell you that many people are scared. They're scared of failure. They're scared they're going to be laughed at. They're scared that they don't know what they're doing. But none of us know what we're doing until we do it. And, you know, that's half the battle. These are things that have helped me in the past. When I played it safe and stay in a box, humdrum, go to work, do the 9-to-5, blah, blah, blah. That's when Tammy is going to get a little down, almost borderline depressed, because I hate mundane things. I'm at my best when I take a swimming lesson. I'm at my best when I play tennis. I'm at my best when I go try out for a stage play, when I sing live in front of an audience. That's when I'm at, like, I'm just feeling so good about myself because those are my gifts and my passions. So same for you. That's what's going to get you to where you want to go. If you want to write a book, go write a paragraph. Go research some publishers. If you want to write a song, just write a poem and turn it into a song. If you want to go back to school, research some different schools. Pick out three, research them. This is the perfect time, lining up for the fall. If you want to buy a house, get your paper together, get your credit report, get motivated. It all starts with something. If you want to lose weight, go outside, walk for 20 minutes, go up and down the stairs for 10. Don't lie to yourself and say, I'm going to join the gym and work out for 7 hours a day, because you're not. 5 hours a day, because you're not. 2 hours a day, you still probably not. Start small and work your way up. I think that's why a lot of people don't succeed, because they bite off more than they can chew. You don't have to overdo it. It starts gradually. And anyway, they recommend that with exercise. Start small and keep building on it. It's not about who works out the most. It's gradually. You're going to see the weight gradually falling off as you gradually change your diet as well. So motivation can come from many things, but the key is to do something. If you sit on your butt, you're not going to get anything done. I can guarantee you that. Now, that much I can promise you. But if you do something, something becomes something magical and something big. Another thing you can do is look up the greats. Look up Oprah Winfrey. Hear her story. Look up Gandhi, Mother Teresa. Dr. Martin Luther King should inspire anybody. I mean, look up his story. Bruce Lee. Even Bruce Lee's quotes alone will inspire you. You can also look at different ministers on YouTube, and they'll inspire you with some of their words. Some ministers, their style don't fit everybody. Find the one that fits you. Check out 20, 30 minute videos. These are things that can keep you going when the rubber meets the road, when you get down in the dumps. And trust you me, something is gonna happen to try to knock you off your square. And I never forget becoming a life coach. And things started going wrong in my life. I remember I had to go for chemo, and I had a client. It was hard to coach under those circumstances, but I remember pushing myself. Even with being a therapist, I have had some things that really upset me, but I had to plop on that chair, and my client is on the couch, and I had to give them the best of Tammy, because they pay hard, cold money for therapy with me, and for me to come in there and tell them about my problems would be shameful. So you got to stay motivated, but also have a plan when things go awry in your life. And trust you me, Murphy's Law, something is going to happen. That's just nature of life and nature, what they say, nature of the beast or whatever. So again, what keeps you motivated? Drop me some comments. I need you on this video so we can let the viewers see what keeps us going. Hit subscribe, hit like. Thank you so much for watching. And 1, 2, 3. But you all like, what's up with her and these jump jacks? It's just something. I wanted to add something a little different to my video. But hit subscribe and like. Thank you for watching. Get motivated. Drop me some comments. Bye. Thank you.